Hello everyone. Let us start with one more type of method, that is Castiglione's method. We have completed strain energy method and we have solved problems on beams, frames and trusses to find the deflection by strain energy method. So we have discussed some limitations of strain energy method. So there are two limitations. First one is the structure is subjected to a single concentrated load, then only you can apply the strain energy method. And second one is deflection required is at the loaded point and is in the direction of load, then only we can find by strain energy method. Correct. So these limitations can be overcome by some of the methods, so which we'll be studying in further classes. So first one is Castiglione's theorem, that is there are two theorems in it, and one more is unit load method. So here in Castiglione's theorem, it is the name of the mathematician whose name is Carlo Alberto Castiglione. Okay, after his name the method is called as Castiglione's method or Castiglione's theorems. There are two theorems in it ultimately to find the deflection and reaction component. So this Carlo Alberto Castiglione published two theorems in 1879. So first theorem helps in determining deflection, second theorem in helps in determining redundant reaction components. So most of the times we will be interested in first theorem, that is to find the deflection. So once we find the deflection, it's not easy to find the reaction components also. Okay, we'll discuss these two theorems and let us solve a few more problems on beams, frames and trusses by Castiglione's theorem. So if you see the first theorem, so the first theorem, it is saying in a linearly elastic structure, partial derivative of the strain energy with respect to load is equal to the deflection of the point where the load is acting, the deflection being measured in the direction of load. Okay, just look into this statement once again. So ultimately it is with respect to strain energy. So in short, if you say it, so differentiation of strain energy stored in a linearly elastic member with respect to the load. Strain energy with respect to load, if you differentiate, then ultimately we will be getting what is the deflection. Okay, so linearly elastic structure, so partial derivative of the strain energy with respect to the load is given by the deflection. Ultimately we will be finding the deflection. So if you differentiate the strain energy stored in that particular structure with respect to the load, but what we need to understand here is the deflection being measured in the direction of the load. So here look at this expression, du upon dp, so or else dou upon dou p is equal to delta. So at point I, if you find the deflection, so the load should be acting in the direction of deflection, that is p. So u is the strain energy stored in the structure. So if you differentiate this strain energy with respect to the load, you will be getting what is the deflection in the direction of load. Correct? The load may be a force or a moment. Mathematically, this theorem may be represented by this. Correct? So again here, so one more is dou u upon dou m. So at point any j, if you differentiate the strain energy with respect to a moment, so it is also nothing but a load. Correct? So you will be getting what is the slope. So the ultimately first theorem of Castiglione's theorem, it says the differentiation of this strain energy with respect to load, so that is p, you will be getting deflection, that is m, you will be getting slope, a couple or a moment. Correct? So either you can find slope and deflection by differentiating the strain energy stored in a member with respect to load, that is p, the moment or couple, that is EM. Okay, so to find deflection, there should be a concentrated load. To find the slope, there should be a couple or a moment. Okay, so where U is the total strain energy. So P and M are the loads, and delta and theta are the deflections. Okay, in general, slope and deflection. Correct. So this is first theorem. So if you look into the proof of this first theorem, so let us consider the simply supported beam. So this is the simply supported beam where it is subjected to three forces which are applied gradually. Okay, a simply supported beam subjected to three loads, P1, P2, P3. So, and delta 1, delta 2, delta 3 are the deflections corresponding to P1, P2, P3. So, but you need to carefully look this as the loads are applied gradually. Okay, so then these are the deflections. So, second figure, again, the same P1, P2, P3, and these are the deflection corresponding to that. But so this particular second figure is subjected to add additional load. Okay, so in addition with these three gradually apply load, so if you apply an additional load, okay, so maybe a DP1, okay, that is the additional load. So apart from these three gradually apply load, if you apply an additional load, then the corresponding additional displacements are d delta 1, d delta 2, d delta 3. Okay, so this is second figure. So first figure, so gradually apply load on the simply supported beam and corresponding displacements. Second figure, so the same with first figure, and additional load is applied, then corresponding displacement. Okay, so just look at here. So consider a simply supported beam shown in figure on which the loads P1, P2, P3 are applied gradually. Let the deflections under the loads P1, P2, P3 are delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. So ultimately what you can write, the strain energy stored in this particular first figure, U is equal to force into displacement, a gradually applied load. So half into P1 into delta 1 plus half into P2 into delta 2 plus half into P3 into delta 3. Similarly, for the second figure, so wherein it is applied an additional load, that is DP1, be added after the loads P1, P2, P3 and applied, and let the additional deflections be D delta 1, D delta 2, D delta 3. Then the additional strain energy stored DU is given by, due to the application of additional load DP1, so the additional strain energy stored in this particular second figure is given by half into DP1 into D delta 1 plus P1 into D delta 1, P2 into D delta 2, P3 into D delta 3. This is an additional strain energy stored. Okay, that is DU due to the application of additional load DP1. So here, so these all are gradually applied load and an additional applied load. Okay, therefore the total strain energy of the entire system, okay, it will be U plus DU is equal to, so add this equation A and equation B. So you will be getting total strain energy of the system. Okay, so here this total strain energy due to the application of gradually applied load plus the additional load DP1, the same thing. So if only P1, that is the gradually applied load P1 plus the additional load DP1, if I add it and apply it, and again P2 and P3 were to be applied simultaneously, if I apply these three as in different loads simultaneously on the simply supported beam, then the strain energy stored is given by, so this is the expression, that is equation number D. Since the final strain energy in both the cases should be same, so what is that? So whatever you have applied, this gradually applied load and additional load, and added them to get the total strain energy. And one more is the DP1, the additional load plus P1, then P2, P3. So if you apply them simultaneously, the principle of superposition ultimately. So ultimately we will be getting equation C must be equal to equation D. So because the final strain energy should be same in both the cases, ultimately the loads are same, correct? Since here applied separately, simultaneously. So if you equate this C equation with the D equation and solve for the displacement delta, so ultimately you will be end up with delta is equal to du upon dp. Okay, differentiation of strain energy with respect to the additional load, whatever we are talking, so that is dp. Okay, so differentiation of strain energy with respect to the load, we'll be getting the deflection. Similarly, if I talk about the moment, then I will be getting the slope. The deflection at any point, the vertical displacement and the slope. Okay, so these are ultimately in general called as deflection. So the load P should be applied and the load M should be applied. Okay, so the second theorem says the partial derivative of the total strain energy in a linearly elastic system with respect to displacement at any point gives the force at that point. Nothing but ultimately this is vice versa. The first theorem, if you differentiate the strain energy stored with respect to load, you will be getting the deflection. So here if you differentiate the strain energy with respect to displacement, you will be getting what is the load. So these are vice versa, that is second theorem. So most of the times we will be stick on to the first theorem, wherein we will be calculating the displacement. Okay, that is deflections. Okay, so before starting solving the problems, so some notes you need to understand here. So according to this Castiglione's theorem, total strain energy stored in a particular structure, you are aware, so U is equal to integration of 0 to L m square by 2 EI into dx. This is the strain energy stored in the member due to the flexure, correct? This is the expression. Already we have solved problems on beams, frames by this particular equation, correct? So according to Castiglione's first theorem, so differentiation of this strain energy with respect to the load, I will be getting the displacement or deflection at a particular point in the direction of the load applied. Okay, so that is I point. So here strain energy, it is m square by 2 EI. So U is m square by 2 EI. If you differentiate with respect to P, this m square by 2 EI, what it will be? M square is 2m divided by 2 EI into dou m by dou P. Correct? So ultimately, if you differentiate with respect to P, so it is 2 times m into dou m by dou P divided by 2 EI. The same thing I have written here. So ultimately the displacement, this delta, according to Castiglione's theorem, delta is equal to integration of 0 to L m into dou m by dou p. So differentiating this with respect to p, so you will be getting m into dou m by dou p divided by ei into dx. So ultimately you need to remember this particular equation. Okay, so either I can use this delta or else this delta, both are same. So either write like this or this. So delta is given by integration of m into dou m upon dou p divided by e into dx. So I hope you got this. So ultimately Castiglione's theorem, the energy stored in a member, so this u is differentiated with p, so you will be getting ultimately this. So integration is 2m, sorry, differentiation dou m upon dou p, okay, divided by 2ei, correct? So this two get cancels, you are left out with m into dou m upon dou p by ei, m into dou m upon dou p by ei into dx. Okay, so you will be remembering this equation in Castiglione's theorem to find the deflection in the direction of load. Okay, so in addition with this, so you may require If there is no load acting at the point where the deflection is required, put a fictitious load at that point in the direction of deflection required and then make it zero before integration and after differentiation. Okay, I hope this is clear. Let me read once again. Suppose here if you are finding in a particular beam the deflection. So let us say this is a cantilever beam. So you might require the deflection at this point. Okay, but there is no load. So the load may be a UDL. Okay, if you want to find the deflection at this point, say the point B. So but there is no concentrated load. So according to this, there should be a concentrated load acting at point B to find the deflection, but there is no load. So in that case, what we need to do? We need to assume a fictitious, or you can say it is a dummy load. Okay, means it is an imaginary load. Okay, dummy load or a fictitious load. It is an imaginary load at point B. So once you find this, so then again find what is the moment. So with the previous equation, moment you will find showed in the member due to that P assumed concentrated load and whatever the load is applied. Then so differentiate that. So before integration, but after differentiation, you need to set that as zero. Okay, so write down the equation, find the moment, everything you will be doing. So then you will be substituting it zero before integration, after differentiation in terms of P. Okay, so once we solve the problem, so you will be understanding this. Okay, so here the one limitation from strain energy what we are talking, so there should be only concentrated loads, but here the load may be anything. So but there should be an additional load acting at the point where the deflection is required, that it should be a concentrated load. Again, there is one limitation, but still, so the load may be UDL, UVL, whatever, but the point about which you are finding the deflection, there should be a concentrated load, that we need to remember here. Similarly, one more note, if a point load is already there at that point and its magnitude is given, assume the magnitude of the load as unknown P, and then put numerical value of load after differentiation and before integration. Okay, suppose you are finding the deflection at point B. Suppose here the load is already present. Okay, so let us say 10 kilonewton. Okay, so the 10 kiloton is there. So in the direction of point B, so we need to find the deflection. So already a force is there. It's not necessary to assume now a fictitious load or a dummy load. Okay, so it's not necessary. So we can assume this load as only a P. Okay, then find the moments and do everything. But you can substitute afterwards the value of P in the equation. Okay, but again, load after differentiation and before integration. In terms of P, find what is the moment. Okay, then write down the equation. Then before integration, but after differentiation, substitute that P value, whatever it is there, that is 10 kN. Only to find the moment, you need to take as a P load. Okay, is I hope it is clear. So here also same. So if load is not there, so you are going to assume the load as P, a fictitious load or a dummy load. So it is just an imaginary load. Actually, there is no load, but we are assuming because we are finding the deflection about the point where the deflection is required. So we need to have a concentrated load. So again, we are setting it to zero, then before integration, after differentiation. So to find the moment, so at a particular section X, so you will be using this particular P load. In terms of P, we need to find the moment. So then set it equal to zero or substitute the value of whatever it is there. Then before integration, but after differentiation. Okay. So one more. If slope at any point is required. Okay, so this is with respect to slope. Slope at any point is required. Call the couple acting at that point as M, or a moment M. Or if there is no couple, put an imaginary couple of moment M. Then find what is the slope required at particular point. Okay, this is with respect to the slope. So to find the deflection, that is displacement, vertical displacement, so you are assuming a fictitious force P, concentrated load. Similarly here, if you want to find the slope at a particular point, then we need to assume the moment or a couple, okay, couple acting at that point where the slope is required. Then again, same thing, after differentiation and before integration, we need to set it as 0, or else if already a couple of value is there, then assume it as M, then do find the what is the moment, then after differentiation, before integration, substitute the value of M. Similarly with respect to the previous notes, okay, this is for slope. So at the end of these notes, what you can understand is, so ultimately if you can find the deflection about the point where the load is acting, if load is acting, that is concentrated load is acting, then no worries, you can assume it as P and calculate what is the moment, then before integration, after differentiation, set equal to whatever the load is there, or else if it is not there, set it to 0. Similarly, if you are finding slope at a particular point, you should be using the couple or a moment, okay, couple of momentum, what you can say, okay, this couple of imaginary moment M, okay, if it is there, assume it as M, find what is the moment in that particular beam, then go ahead with the procedure. So before integration, after differentiation, set it to 0, or else whatever the value is there, you can substitute. Okay, I hope it is clear. So to find the deflection or displacement, a concentrated load is required. To find the slope, a moment is required, or a couple is required at that particular point. Remember these two. When we solve the problems, you will be understanding thoroughly. Okay, let us solve one simple problem to begin with. Find the deflection at the free end of the cantilever beam. Okay, this is a cantilever beam where one end is fixed, other end is free. So where the concentrated load of intensity W is acting at the free end. Okay, this is of span L. So you need to find what is the deflection at free end. So ultimately they are asking what is delta B. Okay, so they are asking what is delta B here. So according to Cassegrain's theorem, so a displacement delta is equal to integration of M into dou M upon dou P divided by EI into DX. So M is there. M means ultimately we need to find what is the moment in this particular beam. So you will cut a section from the free end at a distance X. You will find what is the moment. So the same thing we'll do it. So here consider a section XX from the free end at a distance X. Correct? So here the concentrated load is there in the direction of where that displacement is required. So I will be assuming this W as P. Okay, this W equal to P. In terms of P, I will proceed first. Then I will substitute P is equal to W at the end. Okay, so if you remember those notes. Okay, so I have assumed this concentrated load as P. W is equal to P. So in terms of P, I will find what is the moment. So what will be the moment? So at a section X, cut a section, okay, from right hand side if it is anti-clockwise, from left hand side if it is clockwise, then it will positive. Correct? So this is sign convention. Cut a section from right hand side anti-clockwise, the left hand side clockwise positive. So here the load is rotating clockwise like this. Correct? P into X. So it will be, moment will be minus Px. Correct? So that will be writing here. So you need to make this particular tabular column in this particular method such that it will be easy for to write the equation. Okay, so here portion is only one, AB portion. So origin we are considering it as B. So from this we are taking a section, so that is X, being the B as the origin at a distance X. Okay, the limits, the span 0 to L, then moment, it is minus P into X, minus P into X, force into perpendicular distance, minus PX. Okay, so if you remember this equation, delta is according to Cassegrain's first theorem, delta is given by integration of 0 to L, M into dou M upon dou P divided by E into DX. What is M? Minus PX. And dou M upon dou P is required, correct? So differentiation of this moment with respect to P, that is load. So what it will be? So minus PX, if you differentiate with respect to P, so now it will be remaining minus X. Okay, so again substitute here. So 0 to L, moment is minus PX, and dou M upon dou P is minus X divided by EI into DX. So now we have differentiated. Okay, here in this step we have differentiated. So after differentiation, before integration, now we need to integrate this. We need to set whatever the value. Okay, here the value was given W. So it was given. So if not given, we could have assumed the load as P, imaginary load. We could have again here put P is equal to 0 if we assumed the imaginary load. But here the load was mentioned W. So we have started with assuming it as P. So now put P is equal to W. After differentiation here, before integration here. So set P is equal to W. So then integrate it. So if you do it, you will be ultimately getting WL cube by 3EI. That is minus W into X into minus X. So ultimately minus of minus plus. So WX square. So what is the integration of WX square? WX square. Okay, so it will be WX cube by 3. So that only WX cube by 3 by EI. 3EI, correct? So limit 0 to L is there. So X is L. So WL cube by 3EI. This is the displacement or deflection at the free end of the cantilever beam. I hope it is clear. So let us solve one more problem. So same thing, deflection and slope at free end. So here both deflection and slope we need to find at point B. So what is asked here? So what is delta B and what is theta B, correct? So you need to find what is delta B and what is theta B. Deflection at point B and slope at point B. So here if you see, the loading is uniformly distributed load for the cantilever beam. The type of beam is cantilever. Span is L. Okay. So only one region. So again cut a section from free end considering B as the origin at a distance X and find the moment. But before that, to find the deflection and to find the slope, what should be there at point B? So first find what is the deflection. To find the deflection, what should be there? There should be a concentrated load acting here, correct? Like this. So if it is not there, then assume. So this is a dummy load, a fictitious load, correct? A dummy load, a fictitious load, nothing but it is an imaginary. Actually, it is not there. To find, so we are assuming, correct? So a dummy load we are assuming. So what is, if you assume, so here we have assumed P as the dummy load, imaginary load, since the load is not acting at point B. So now B as the origin at a distance X, we need to find what is the moment. The same thing, cut a section right hand side anti-clockwise, then positive. So you are cutting a section here, this is section XX. So right hand side you are considering what is the moment. This UDL is making clockwise and this concentric load is rotating clockwise, correct? Both are rotating clockwise. So due to concentric, what is the moment? So P into X, since it is clockwise, so it will be minus, minus PX. Due to this UDL, what is the moment at this section? So from here to here, W, W into X correct? That is the total load W into X into, so here it will be acting half into X by 2. So ultimately what is the moment? W into X by 2, W X square by 2, but it is rotating again clockwise. If it is anti-clockwise, positive. Since it is rotating clockwise, so it is minus. Minus W X square by 2, then due to constant load, minus P X. So that only we have written here. Portion, so AB or BA. Origin, we are considering B. So limits 0 to L. Moment, due to concentrated load, minus Px. Due to UDL, minus W into X square by 2. Correct? So again, since we have assumed the fictitious member here, P, okay, we need to have the differentiation now in terms of P, because dou m by dou p is required. For that reason, so we have considered a fictitious load. So now do the differentiation. What will be the differentiation of this moment with respect to P? So only P term is here. So this term will be 0. So here minus Px with respect to P, differentiation will be minus X. Correct? So we have done the differentiation. So what is the rule? So set P is equal to 0 before integration. Now we have done the differentiation. Now we need to have the integration. We need to set equal to 0. Correct? So here, if you substitute the equation M, moment is minus Px minus Wx square divided by 2. So this is a moment. Then dou m by dou p, it is minus X, correct, divided by EI into dx. So now in this, set P is equal to 0. If you set P is equal to 0, what is remaining? So minus W X square by 2 into minus X, minus or minus plus. So ultimately W X cube, X square into X, X cube, W X cube by here. Wx cube by 2ei, this 2, this ei, 2ei, 0 to L. So after setting P equal to 0, because we have assumed in the beginning, it is an imaginary load, correct? Minus Px minus Wx square by 2 into minus X. So set P equal to 0. After differentiation, before integration, set 0. Okay, directly I have written here. So it will be Wx cube by 2EI into dx. Now do the integration. So what will be the integration? X cube. Integration will be x raised to 4 by 4. Correct? So W x raised to 4 by 4. 4 into 2, it is 8. So W x raised to 4 by 8EI. So 0 to L, substitute the value of x, that is limits L. So it will be ultimately W L raised to 4 by 8EI. Okay, this is the displacement at the free end of the cantilever beam. Okay, so in this problem, they have asked the displacement or deflection and also the slope. So now to find the slope at point B, again, there is no moment here. To find slope, what is required? A fictitious moment we need to assume, M. Okay, then we need to cut a section and we need to find what is the moment at a distance x. See here, slope at free end. Okay, here what I will do, I will assume a moment, a clockwise moment. It is an assumption. Okay, it is an fictitious moment or dummy moment or imaginary moment. Actually, it is not there, we are assuming it. Okay, so what is the moment at this section x? So this is section xx, so B as the origin. What is the moment? Due to this moment, it is already a moment, it will be constant. So according to sign convention, cut a section, if it is anti-clockwise right hand side, then positive. So but it is rotating clockwise right hand side, so it is minus M. Okay, moment at a distance x, section xx will be minus M, since it is rotating clockwise. It will be a moment which will be constant throughout from here to here. Then due to this UDL, w into x into x by 2, like previous problem, minus, since it is w x into x, so it will be w x square by 2, correct? So that only I have written here. Portion BA, origin B, limits 0 to L, the moment of inertia, it is I, so here it is required, so but here it is constant, it is I, then moment, okay, so moment is minus m minus wx square by 2, minus m minus wx square by 2, then dou m by dou p, so we have assumed this m, so we'll do the differentiation, but before integration we need to make it as 0, correct, remember that. So if you do the differentiation, dou m by dou m is with respect to this couple of moment m, so this term will be 0, so minus m, the differentiation with respect to m will be minus 1, okay. So again, if you write this, okay, so if you substitute in this equation, so here if I substitute integration, so this moment is minus m minus w x square by 2, then dou m by dou m, so it will be minus 1 divided by ei, correct, into dx. So now after differentiation, we have done the differentiation, but before integration we need to make it as 0. If you make it this as 0, what is remaining? So this term, that is minus wx square by 2, and this minus 1, minus of minus, it will be plus wx square by 2. So wx square by 2. So your integration with respect to x, so w here constant outside, w by 2ei. So this 2ei, integration of x square. What is the integration of x square? X cube by 3. So denominator 3 is there, 3 into 2 it is 6, wx cube by 3, so within the limit 0 to L, so the ultimately it will be w L cube by 6 ei. I hope you can do the integration, okay, so do the integration, so substitute within the limits, so ultimately you are getting what is the slope at point B, okay, theta, it is w L cube by 6 ei. So for this problem, we have found what is the slope and what is the deflection at free end. So there was no concentrated load, there was no concentrated moment. So but we have assumed it, and then we have made it 0 before integration, but after differentiation. Okay, so I hope it is clear, the slope. So similarly, so one more problem to find the deflection at the free end, but here at free end, so that is at point B, the concentrated load is given, okay, the value of concentrated load is given, there is a concentrated load acting at point B of intensity 10 kN. So how to proceed with this problem? So what we need to do, so we need to assume this 10 kN as P in the beginning. So at a distance x from free end, find what is the moment. So what will the moment in terms of p? P into x, since it is rotating clockwise. So minus px, moment will be minus px according to sign convention. Cut a section right hand side, anti-clockwise positive. So cut a section right hand side, it is rotating clockwise. So it is minus px. Okay, then do the differentiation in terms of px, then before integration set p as 10 kN. Okay, so this is the procedure, so we'll go ahead with this. So at a section x, assuming 10 kN as p, so find the moment. What is the moment? Minus px. So portion is ba, origin is b, limits, it is a to b is 2 meters, so limits is 0 to 2. Okay, then moment at a distance x, it will be minus p into x, that is minus 10x. Okay, so actually we need to write here minus px, minus 10x, or else minus px. So if you differentiate with respect to p, so what it will be, dou m by dou p will be with respect to p, it will be minus x, correct? So p term is there, x term is there, we are differentiating with respect to p, don't look this. So what it will be, minus px, nothing but minus x, correct? So once you do the differentiation, so now here we need to set p as 10 kilonewton. So here, so this differentiation is done in terms of p. So we have found the moment in terms of p, minus px, moment is minus px, dou m by dou p is minus x with respect to p. I hope it is clear. So now equation, the displacement according to Cassellian's theorem, integration m into dou m upon dou p dou by ei into dx, the deflection is equal to 0 to L. So moment is what? Minus px. This is minus px into dou m by dou p is minus x, minus px into minus x divided by ei, correct? So after differentiation, before integration, so now we are doing integration, so set p equal to 10, correct? So we have assumed 10 equal to p, so now set p equal to 10. So if you set p equal to 10, it is minus 10x into minus x, same thing, minus x divided by ei within the limit 0 to 2. Limit is given 0 to 2. Okay, so what it will be, minus of minus, it will be plus, plus 10x square by ei, 10x square by ei dx within the limit 0 to 2, correct? So 10 by ei outside, constant, you are integrating with respect to dx, that is x term, so it will be x cube by 3. Then 0 to 2, substitute the limit values, so ultimately you will be getting delta is 80 by 3EI, so nothing but 26.67 by EI. Okay, so the displacement will be 26.67 by EI. Okay, so three varieties of problems we have solved. Okay, so which are those? This was the first problem where W was given, we have assumed this one as P, and we have found what is the displacement, correct? Then W will go by 3EI. So here slope and deflection was required at the free end where there is no concentrated load, there is no moment. So we have first assumed the concentrated load P, then we have found what is the deflection at the free end, W will go raised to 4 by 8EI. Then slope at point B was required, we have assumed the moment, okay? Then we have found what is the slope at point B, WL cube by 6EI. Then one more problem. So concentrated load was given. So what will be the deflection? So we have assumed this as P. Then ultimately we have found what is the deflection at free end. So it is 26.67 by EI. Similarly, so we will find what is the slope at free end when concentrated load is given but moment is not there. So now we need to find the slope at point B, but at point B there is no moment or a couple. Okay, so first we need to assume this moment at point B and cut a section at a distance x, keeping B as the origin. At a distance x, section xx, what is the moment? So it will be cut a section right hand side if it is anti-clockwise positive. So due to this 10 kilonewton moment will be, so now 10 into x rotating clockwise, so minus 10 into x, correct? So now I will write in terms of 10 only. Now I will not assume p, that is over the previous one. Now it is slope is required, a moment. Okay, so since moment is required, I will assume the moment. So what is the, due to this moment, m constant, minus 10 x minus m, so the same thing. So at a distance x from point B, 10 is the load as it is, I will assume the moment m. So once you assume the moment m, so portion AB, origin is B, limits is 0 to 2, moment minus 10 x minus m, what we have discussed, correct? So now do the differentiation in terms of m. So what it will be, this term will be 0, so here m term is there, minus 1 will be the differentiation of m, Okay, so now substitute this in this equation, but before integration you need to set m as 0. Okay, so if I write this again, integration m is what, minus 10x minus m, this is moment, dou m by dou m, it is minus 1 divided by ei into dx, correct? Yes. Okay, within the limits it is 0 to 2. Now you are doing integration, so what we need to do, so this m we need to make it 0 before integration, after differentiation. Differentiation here we have done. So now before doing integration, set m equal to 0. So what is remaining? Minus 10x minus 1, minus of minus, it will be plus 10x. So plus 10x divided by e into dx, within the limit 0 to 2. 10 by e outside, constant, x term integration, it is x square by 2. Substitute the limits 0 to 2. So ultimately you will be getting the slope as 20 by e at the free end. Okay, this is the slope at free end point B. Okay, so I hope it is clear. So we'll stop it here. We'll solve a few more problems in further classes. Thank you.